Welcome back to Proactive Investors New York. With me on Skype today is Ric Schumacher from Pressure BioSciences. Ric, good to see you.
Good to see you again, Christine. Thanks for having me on.
Sure. Ric, recently we spoke about the company inking an agreement with its BaroShear technology. Now we see the company making progress with its BaroShear technology. How does this technology work, first off?
Well, about a year ago, we developed a procedure called UltraShear technology, where we combine ultra-high pressure, and we're a world expert in using ultra-high pressure, with shearing or cutting forces. And in that area, we think 1 + 1 = 5. We now have an instrument system in which we're able to put material in and process it through this ultra-high pressure through a valve at the end that shears or cuts the material. And in essence, it basically breaks the material down, if you're using an oil, into what we call a nano-emulsion. The drops of oil get so small that they're smaller than the wavelength of light. The material becomes clear, and it becomes much, much more absorbable because it's so small. So in the case of CBD, CBD comes out of the plant in an oil. It's very hard for human bodies, animal bodies, to absorb CBD in an oil form. And yet, if you break it down into a very small oil droplet, a nano emulsion, it makes it much easier, and the CBD inside the oil becomes much more soluble, much more bioavailable, and therefore available for the body to do its thing.
Well, yeah, you mentioned CBD. Congratulations is in order because Pressure has signed its first customer to use BaroShear. The customer is Nano CBD Cosmetics. How will BaroShear really benefit from Nano CBD's products?
Nano CBD is a terrific company. They've been in the CBD business for quite some time, and they spent a lot of money, a lot of time developing their own process to make nano emulsions. They have a process, and they basically said, you know, guys, we need to grow. We need to make a lot more product. We're running out of product right now as it is. We believe that your instrument and system will make a better product than ours, and we also believe it can scale and scale well. So we're going to switch over to yours. And they gave us a purchase order a couple of days ago for $200,000 to purchase the first of our BaroShear instruments.
So when can NanoCBD begin using BaroShear?
We are taking orders, as we said in a press release a couple of weeks ago. We're pre-selling the instrument. The instrument's going to be rather expensive for parts. Everything is custom made. You cannot get this system off the shelf. We are custom making and custom designing a number of the key parts of the instrument. We have two patents that are also part of this instrument system. And so it's an extremely difficult system to make, but we're going to make it. We're going to make about 12 systems to start, which is more than we usually make on an initial run. It will take us about 6 months. So we promised Nano CBD Cosmetics and other companies that we're talking to that probably within 6, at the most 8 months, we'll be installing their BaroShear K45 system in their own laboratory for their own use.
So you're making 12 instruments, but you say that you have around half a dozen deals in the pipeline. That kind of leaves 6 more instruments available to you. So, I mean, what do you think the market will? How do you think the market will react to that?
I don't know. We're hoping that that this will be a message. We are talking to a number of companies already, but there are 5 or 6 that are moving along the line to a point where we have a proposal from one that came in the other day. We're expecting a proposal for 1 or 2 more others. And so we're very optimistic that over the next few days or weeks, that probably more than half of the systems that we're going to build are going to be spoken for with purchase orders. And we're hoping that that the other companies that we're talking to, which is quite a lot, will step up the interest and step up discussions with us. Our goal as a company is to get these pre-sold as quickly as possible so that we can start ordering the parts. The parts, again, are fairly expensive and very custom made. And we need, the sooner we get them ordered, the sooner we start getting the systems made. And that means the sooner they get installed and used in the field.
Well, you've publicly said that you would double revenue by Q2 of 2020. How does this kind of fit into that overall plan?
Well, my lawyers aren't happy that I said that, but I think it's important for our shareholders. We have a number. We have about 1,700 shareholders as a publicly traded company, and many of them have been very patient. We did $2.4 million in 2018. and 2.1 million in 2017, 1.8 million in 2016, all in our pressure cycling technology platform. As you know, we have 28 patents that talk to three different platforms. UltraShear is the most recent and the newest platform. And our patient investors have been waiting for what we think will be an opening up and acceptance of our biotechnology customers to our new system, the BaroCycler Extreme. And they are, but it's taking a lot longer than we had expected. And so we are opportunistic. We looked at this market of CBD. We know that we can fix one of the most critical problems, and that's making CBD oil become more water-soluble so that it can be absorbed better by the human and animal body. If we sell 12 instruments, and we've already said the price is $195,000, so 12 instruments times about $200,000 is $2.4 million, equals our total sales in our biotechnology business. So we're very excited that we think that by 2020, just 1 year from now, our revenue could be twice where it is now just by selling these 12 instruments that we're committed to making.
Great to hear about the company's progress. Ric, thanks so much for your time.
Thank you. Appreciate being on.